Andy, why don't you tell me what brings you down here today?
A car.
You don't know how many times I've heard that answer.
I know. Jesus, I'm real clever, aren't I? I just came down. I'm a fan of the show.
No stories about you out there that might pop up, right?
No. I don't rate gossip. And I got some bodies in my basement, but they'll find out about this,
Eventually.
Yeah, eventually.
So, expecting anything in there today? Nervous about going in? It's the first time you're up here, right?
Yeah. No, not really. I don't know. I don't think much.
Like, Conan's done the show once, right? I mean, once, twice.
A couple of times, yeah.
Did he give you any advice? Did he know you were coming on?
No, I don't think. Well, I didn't talk to him about it, But I don't know. I fully expect him to say crappy things about Conan. Because God knows he's said them in the past. So, but he's always said, fairly nice things about me, except I send a Christmas card. I don't know. I called Gary once to try and get him to spend some money at my friend's business, and then I send a Christmas card. It's probably, everybody probably thinks I'm some sort of creepy stalker or something.
Andy Richter's here. He is the co-host of the Conan O'Brien Show.
Right.
He's the sidekick. He's like the Ed McMahon.
Yes, that would be true.
But I think that's an insult to call him the Ed McMahon. It is, right?
It is.
Yeah, because Ed's such a dolt.
I'm hoping I'll do better than...
You get to do more than Ed did, I think. Well, though he used to introduce Aunt Flabby and stuff, and you get to introduce Conan's characters.
And aren't you in some of... He was in some of the skits, too, wasn't he?
Yeah, and he gets to be in some of the skits.
Oh, there we go. I got it.
Yeah, you get a segment every night. You get to be in the skits. But when Conan's interviewing, Andy's got to shut his mouth.
Right. He just stays there at the end of the show.
I don't have to shut my
mouth. Yeah, but you do. Because everyone will go, look at him trying to be like the interviewer.
That's it.
When I went on the Conan show, I tried to at least address Andy a couple of times because it's like...
It is odd because he's sitting right there.
Yeah, and you feel kind of bad for the guy just sitting there on the goddamn couch not doing anything.
I mean, what kind of job is that?
Well, as I like to say, the check cashes the same either way. So.
That's it, my friend. There you go.
Feel bad for me. I'm making a living.
I got a million questions.
The back of people's heads.
I got a million questions for you. Like, how'd you get that job? You know what I mean? But
yeah.
Mike Walker's online. Mike.
Howard, never been a whiff of scandal about Andy. That's kind of interesting. I'm jotting this down. Let's look into Andy Richter.
Oh, now they're going to start investigating you.
Andy would be thrilled.
And would you be thrilled, Andy?
I would.
Oh, okay. Well,
I would be really.
He hopes you find something.
I know. I'm actually thinking now. Geez, I got to go do something.
Yeah, it's right. Andy puts off stage. You're probably pretty much like but kind of like a very dull kind of a.
Well, he's a family man. But that'll change.
Is he married?
I'm married, yeah, but I'm
but
family.
You cheat, right?
No.
Oh, you don't?
I don't. I have next to no libido, so.
Really?
It's not a problem.
You're not gay?
No.
Really?
Not gay, no drugs.
I don't know any guy who doesn't have a libido.
You just met one.
I don't believe
well
it.
Hid.
You really, I can't see you not having a libido.
Well, I mean, I do, but I...
Ever think about the broads you could be getting now if you weren't married?
I'm really just like, I'm such a wuss about it that, and the thing too is that I don't like to talk to people very much. I'm in the right business.
But, yeah, right.
It's like, actually, if I ever think about hey, if I was single and had this job, I'd think, Jesus, how many moronic conversations I'd have to have.
Come on, that's a bull.
No, it's not.
When you're aroused. I talked about this yesterday. When there's a beautiful woman and you're aroused, you'll never know if you'll like her until after you finish orgasming. Because I can't think straight until I'm done. And then I realize, hey, I don't even like her.
Right.
But I gotta have it. Gotta have it.
I'm very distracted by the tear in the real doll's mouth.
I did that.
Oh, that poor thing.
There's an actual tear in her mouth.
Well, Norm MacDonald did that.
She's disintegrating.
Yeah. Yeah. He was in here yesterday messing around with her.
Why does she tear? I mean, what kind of deal is this?
I used her, but I'm not big enough to tear her lips.
Is there a warranty? I mean, can you get that fixed?
I don't need a warranty.
Or will they just ship up a new head?
Andy, feel her chest. Tell me that doesn't feel good. Look at it. Take off her bra.
It's cold.
Take off her. Oh,
you can put her in the tub and warm her up.
That's what they tell you to do.
This is like necrophiliac's delight.
No, you put her in the tub, she gets warm skin.
Oh, really?
Andy, put your hand in her pants and feel her most. most wonderful of places. Isn't that wild?
Oh, God. It's like moss.
Yeah. All right, anyway. Hey, wait a second. Here's a guy who says has dirt on you.
Oh, Andy. Really?
Yeah, let's hear
good.
It.
Excellent. Mike, we got a scoop for you.
All right, here's a scoop. You can put this in the Inquirer. For Danny, go ahead. What do you got on Andy Richter?
Yeah, Howard.
Yeah.
Yeah, about a month ago, I seen Andy and his wife wearing Billy's topless.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, you went to a strip bar with your wife?
Hey,
yeah.
Cool.
Hey, there's something good for you.
Absolutely.
Andy Richter.
So quiet.
Billy's topless.
Andy Richter and his wife go to Louise Topless. Yeah, you
Billy's
take your wife
Billy's
to strip.
Topless.
Oh, Billy's Topless.
Billy's
Why
topless.
Do you go to a strip club with your wife?
She, because she sits at the rail. She's like an old woman at a slot machine.
Yeah.
She sits there at the rail and just hands out dollars. Like, there you go.
Honey. Do you ever say to her, "Hey, honey, how about that one? Like, would you like just theoretically, like it, her? Would you, you know, the three of us? Do you things
you ever,
like that?
You ever,
use it to turn yourself on? That
you ever suggest
good.
A threesome with a stripper?
No.
I don't mean you do it.
No.
But I mean, no.
No. No. I mean,
what's the point? Though? Why is your wife like going? Is she like into chicks?
No, it's yeah. like because it's you know it's.
Well, come on, man.
No, it's,
what's up?
It's funny. I mean, you got to go to Billy's Topless first of all.
It ain't funny.
It's like oh, it's.
I don't find it funny.
It's fun.
What's so funny
it's fun.
About it?
It's fun. Tell me what's so funny about it.
I don't get funny about it. Is that,
well, it's funny because it's like just kind of like this really normal neighborhood tavern. And then there's like these women doing this nude Tai Chi over in, you know,
yeah.
the side.
I'm not cracking up yet.
Yeah, I don't get the joke.
I'm not laughing.
I ain't laughing.
Sorry. Jeez.
Well, I don't Listen, get, anybody
Howard.
Find that funny?
Howard, women.
You know hangout,
what is it?
You know whose hangout that is?
Whose hangout is
it? Freddy's hangout.
Oh, Fred hangs out. Yeah, but he don't take his wife.
No, he doesn't take his wife.
Take a woman to scores. Take your wife to scores. It's kind of fun. Women like watching other women. Now, that's a fact, right?
Yeah, well, you know what? I don't go to watch other women. Please.
Howard, Billy.
They're usually intrigued to be in a place that they don't usually. I've had lots of women say, "Hey, take me to scores."
Yeah, they just want to watch their men. That's not about the women.
I don't know, man.
No, that's not
these
true.
Like,
and you know, Andy's sitting there.
Enough.
He's getting excited from the
yeah,
buzz.
He's claiming to have no libido, and then the next thing we know,
you're
he's at Billy's Topless.
Topless.
Yeah. Billy's, yeah, I'm at Billy's
fact,
Topless
the item,
with a ball
there?
Peen hammer
Andy
banging
Richard
on my crotch, trying to get some life out of
me. He's got no libido. Was spotted at Billy's Topless. I've got my item.
Thank you.
Some item.
Hey, thanks, Mike.
Thanks a lot.
Amazing.
All right, man.
Bye.
Mike Walker, everybody. So, Andy.
Yeah.
Andy Richter's here from the Conan O'Brien show. Hey, let me take a break, and then
okay.
we'll chat a little bit.
It's your show.
Really?
I'll just keep turning her fingers back, the real doll's fingers.
I just want to know how you got the job, being the co-host of the...
Yeah, we all know how Conan got the job.
Yeah, how did Conan get the
Remember
job?
Remember there was this whole talent search across the country? NBC and, interviewed every comedian in the country and couldn't find anybody?
And then they said, you know what, we can't find anyone, so we'll just hire Conan. I mean, how embarrassing was that whole thing?
I mean, it was a really sad
It
situation.
Really was. It really was awful. So, how do you become Conan O'Brien's sidekick? Because, like, were you in show business even or anything?
Yeah, yeah.
What
yeah.
were you doing?
I was a pool boy
No, really, what were you doing?
I did improv in Chicago. So
oh,
I was
you
doing,
did? Yeah, and you got like, paid and everything?
Not really.
Oh.
You know, occasionally, wherever we were working, they'd let us have a free drink or two. But
all right, that's cool.
But then I also did the Real Life Brady Bunch, which played here in
in Broadway, yeah.
Oh, so you were in show business.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, okay.
So
I mean, I just wasn't in any show business. Yeah, I was
comedian,
an actor.
Kind
yeah,
of.
Yeah, I was
comedian.
An actor,
right.
An improv actor.
Okay.
You know? So,
if we said, now remember when
Mike Douglas?
That? Mike Douglas used yeah. to do that with Sandy Barrett.
All right, do me a favor. I'm a tree that has just fallen down.
Right.
And you're a squirrel picking my nuts.
Uh-huh.
And, okay, let's go with that. Go.
Okay.
Now,
did Michael Kennedy just crash into you, tree?
Hey, you see, that's good. That's good. Yeah, he did, that little bastard Kennedy. You know, and I'm glad I took him out because he was with a 14-year-old. And screw Kathy Lee. Hey, nice. Nice bit of improv on my part.
Oh,
yeah.
Wow.
How do you get involved in that improv stuff?
You
yeah.
can do that.
Hey, I'm pretty good at it, too.
It sounds like it's, you're getting some important stuff out
yeah,
of it.
Yeah, man. I'm working through some material here. That improv really goes.
So that's what you do? Have people yell up things and you do them?
Okay, go yell something at me and Andy. We'll do some improv.
Okay.
All right. Go ahead, Robin. Premise.
You're a woman.
Thank you.
Who's lost in New York.
Okay.
And Andy is a stranger on the corner.
Okay, here we go.
Okay.
Excuse me? Are you a black man? Good. I see
well,
a white.
Yes, I am.
I'd like to ask you directions. I'm very lost here in New York. Do you do you know where I can find what's the name of that strip club?
Billy's Topless.
Billy's Topless.
It's obvious you're bisexual.
There you go. Nice.
I happen to know of a few places.
What was that guy who used to go Mike Douglas and do the improv? Sandy
Baron.
Sandy Baron.
I don't remember. I don't know.
Oh, man. How old are you?
I'm 31.
Yeah, you see, I'm 43. I used to watch the Mike Douglas show every day.
I mean, I saw it, but I mean, it, you know, I
you
mean,
were too
I
young to appreciate it.
I was too young to know what was going
on. You didn't get the names
or
anything.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Mike would sit there like a piece of cardboard. You could see him just reading off the teleprompter. And it was just unbelievable. He would read off the teleprompter, and then he'd have Sandy Baron on, and he'd say, Sandy, you're so great at improv. The audience is going to yell out some things. You'd have them on little cards, actually. You go, the audience has written these things down. Now, promise us you haven't seen these. That's right, Mike. I haven't seen these.
That's true.
That's true. And then he'd go, okay, you're a tree, and I'm a squirrel. And they would improv, and it would go nowhere.
Uh-huh.
It would be so unfunny. It would be so unfunny.
As soon as Mike's part came.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Mike would drive the thing right into the ground. Unbelievable. All right. Situation.
Yeah.
Your wife has poison ivy of the vagina.
Okay.
Okay?
Mm-hmm.
And you have to tell me that she gave it to me last night. Go ahead.
That she gave you. All right, Your wife gave me poison ivy.
Oh, no, I got it. It's better. He's just found out he's HIV positive, and you were his last partner.
Okay, let's go with that.
Wow, that is hilarious.
Hello. Oh, Andy. Hello. By the way, last night was wonderful.
Thanks, Howard.
I feel so comfortable in your arms. I really do. You really are fabulous.
Well, I hope you feel comfortable there, because we share more than what we just shared.
What happened to your gay voice? Where is it?
You're so masculine.
Sorry. Oh, you're so butch.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Yeah.
I had some serious news to tell you.
What is it?
I tried to be.
What's the thing?
I'm HIV positive.
What? What?
What? What?
Thank God all I did was fellatio with you. I can't get it from that, can I?
No.
All right.
About that.
All right, listen to me.
Wow, that was
this is a pretty good improv.
Up,
yeah, hey, man, I like this. All right, here's one.
All right.
You just found out that Conan likes little boys.
Okay.
And I'm a cop. Go ahead.
Okay.
Okay. All right,
so
never mind.
Officer, you know where I could get any little boys for my boss?
What are you talking about? Isn't your boss Conan O'Brien?
Yeah.
He's into little boys?
Look, I gotta go.
Hey, you're pretty good at this. No wonder they tapped you for the job. All right, so wait a second. Explain to me real quick how you get the job. Yeah, go ahead.
You know Robert Smigel.
Guy who does the cartoons on Saturday Night Live. Real talented guy.
And he also is the guy that does all the lips in our things.
Oh, okay.
Go ahead.
Bill Clinton, that's Robert.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Yeah.
Okay.
He was the original head writer and producer. He worked with Conan on SNL.
Okay.
I had a friend that worked on SNL.
Good.
I met Robert like a year before in L.A. He was out there writing the Hans and Franz movie.
You're kidding.
No, yeah.
They never produced that, did they?
No, because Arnold thought that people didn't want to see him making fun of himself after Last Action Hero.
Oh, really?
So he said, I'm not going to do it.
Yeah, Arnold's becoming a very deep thinker.
Yeah.
Oh, Arnold was supposed to be in the Hans and Franz movie?
Oh, yeah. He was the linchpin.
Really?
Yeah,
He was the reason it was being made.
Yeah.
Gee, I wouldn't even think you needed him for it.
Things that, from what Robert told me, it sounded like he had some pretty funny ideas. A
couple of comedy ideas.
Yeah, okay. Some funny comedy things.
Might have made a good sketch.
Yeah, comedies with a K.
Right.
So I met him there, and we just hung out. You know, we just kind of became friends. And then the Brady Bunch ended in L.A. That's what I was out there doing.
Right.
I did Cabin Boy. I was back out in L.A. for that.
Right.
And then my phone just rang one day, and it was Robert saying, you know, I know this Conan guy.
Did you have to audition?
No. I was hired as a writer first.
Oh, you were?
Yeah, they hired me. I was the first writer hired on the show.
Oh, I didn't
Robert
know
just called me and said, you want to try and be a writer on the show? And I was like, yeah. You know,
why not?
I'm not doing anything else.
Hey, I did Cabin Boy and the Brady Bunch. Yeah. I might as well do this.
Yeah, I'll come back.
Yeah.
So, yeah, and it was a good excuse to come back to New York. So, I met with Conan at a deli. You got a free lunch out of it.
Right.
submitted.
And you said to yourself, hey, okay, the guy doesn't have much going on with him, but hey, maybe I'll outshine him and they'll give me the show. Is that it?
Yeah, I thought maybe I can just park my ass on a couch.
You know? Yeah, watch this guy die.
Yeah, whatever.
Whatever.
Get the angle on people's plastic surgery.
Right.
You know?
Right. So then he said, okay, hey, and then he basically said to you, I want you to be my sidekick?
That kind of came about as, you know, they found out how hilarious I was.
Oh, okay, cool.
You know?
All right.
As, you know, hanging around the office. Because when I got hired, they didn't, you know.
And what do? Do they, like, test it out in front of an audience one night?
Yeah, well, it started out like in, you know, like there were early test shows with no
audience.
Yeah, and they just kind of said, go sit next to him. Yeah. You know,
boy, there's a lot of pressure. You know? Go make this guy look funny.
So, well, yeah, right. Well, that's not, you know, but go sit next to him. And so, and then as it, we did test shows with audiences,
and they liked you.
At a certain point, well, it's like at a certain point, they bought me more than one suit.
And, right.
And the weird one was one night after a test show. They said, keep your suit on because you're supposed to go to dinner. You're going to go to dinner with Conan and Lorne Michaels.
Mm.
So Conan and I get into Lorne's car. It drives us to a restaurant. We get out and walk in, and there's Lorne and Steve Martin.
Wow.
And then it's like Conan and, you know, I mean, it's like the first, it's
like
all
date.
So new and weird,
yes,
you know.
They're doubling.
You know, and then so we just sit there, and it's like Lorne Michaels and Steve Martin are sitting there, and they just start talking.
What do you talk to them about?
They talk to each other, and
you know what's weird about this?
Nod.
When my movie first came out, Lorne and Steve Martin invited me to dinner with them.
Really? Seriously?
And you didn't go?
I didn't go because I said, "What am I gonna?" First of all, I'm in awe of Steve Martin. I think
yes.
Steve Martin's brilliant.
Absolutely.
I was just kind of like,
Yeah, and I just went, "What am I gonna do?" I don't know. You know
I
me.
I mean, come on.
I just thought, I'm going to have to sit there. I'm going to get gas. I can't fart in front of these guys. I mean, what is it going to be, you know? Lauren's so goddamn proper. You know what I mean? And I never went.
You robbed us of the story.
Yeah, I know. They called me about 10 times. So you actually went.
Yeah, but I didn't. I wasn't expecting Steve Martin.
You didn't know Steve was going to be.
Yeah, that was.
Are those
that
two
was
dating or something? I mean, why is it always Lorne Michaels and Steve Martin? So does Steve say anything? I hear he's a real prick, is he?
No, he was nice.
Nice, yeah.
I mean, it was obvious that he was a swinger.
Yeah. <you know>. Yeah.
Just from the way he looked at me.
And so they just, like, what did they do? Impart some comedy wisdom to you or something?
Yeah, it was kind of, it was a lot of, you know, the thing you'll learn about this business and the thing you'll learn about TV. You know, and I mean, it was fun, you know, but I mean, you got to look at it from my perspective of.
Who wants
you
that?
You know, here I'm coming from.
But yeah,
like
now,
you said, you know, like, were you even in show business? And sometimes I wasn't sure myself.
Right.
And all of a sudden they're, Lorne Michaels and Steve Martin and they're paying for dinner. You know?
Yeah, I wonder what they would have said to me.
You never know now. You'll never know.
Yeah, believe me, I'm okay with that.
I'm not.
I know. Anyway, see Andy Richter on the Conan O'Brien show every night.
Every night, Monday through Friday.
Monday through Friday, and now you guys have a regular contract, right?
I got to tell you, Howard, I'm over in Monte Carlo, and they got those international stations on the hotel TV.
Yeah.
Do you know that Conan comes on every night over there because NBC is broadcast into the hotel?
Yeah, the country's furious about it.
Jay Leno.
there's a protest going
on.
What
is this?
Yeah. No, you get to see those shows.
It's all over the world. My dad was in Russia. And
Could you be making serious scratch from this show yet, or are they still treating you like a second-class citizen?
You know, there's just not that much money at 12:30.
Yeah, but you're all over the world.
Yeah, there must be. You know what? They always say that, but there's some money in it.
How
do you know there's no money? Then why don't they just close down?
Well, that's what they say when they say when I say, "Hey, how come I'm not rich?"
You know, Ed McMahon is worth $80 million.
That's right.
Wow, dude, the sidekick thing can work.
Yeah, but you know,
don't fall for it when they tell you there's no money. I mean, it infuriates me that Ed McMahon has $80 million.
I know. I don't
know
how he got it.
Yeah.
We're just having a big discussion in the office. I mean, what do you think Andy's salary is? I mean, because John and I were just talking.
What does John think?
He thinks it's $500,000. I think he's crazy.
You think that's too much or too little?
I think it's too much. I don't think he gets $500,000 a year.
Really?
Do you?
Come on, it's a national show.
At what point?
You make him more than $500,000?
Yeah.
You are?
Yeah.
$1 million?
No.
Wow. He's making more than $500,000.
So what do you think, Baba Booey?
I think that's
look at Andy. Like, Andy's all proud of himself.
I think
like,
that's great for him.
Yeah, I'm totally puffed up.
No, you know what I'm laughing about? He's talking to a puppet.
I think that's great for him. I just didn't think it would be that hot.
Baba Booey. Baba Booey.
Yeah, but the guy's on camera and stuff.
Yeah, I mean, I'm on TV after
and
all.
And it is a national network show.
Yeah.
We got real advertisers, like, you know.
They're paying you too much, man.
DD7 and stuff like that.
Well, John makes about $80 a week, so he's, like, pissed off anybody gets
Absolutely.
Any money.
Well, I'm sorry. You know?
All right. Well, listen,
no,
you take it up
me,
with John.
I know I'm lucky, but, you know, just wait.
Yeah, man.
You know?
Come on, man. Well, put yourself down. We'll put
you're
you down.
You're talented.
Oh,
yeah.
All right.
You're talented. All right. All right, listen, Andy Richter on the Conan O'Brien Show. See him every night. You doing anything else? Or just the Conan O'Brien Show? I'll plug anything. You got a 1-800 number or anything?
No.
A web page?
You got Andy Richter web page?
No, nothing. No. There's some people maintain them.
Right, but you don't have your own webpage.
No.
You should get a webpage.
For what?
I don't know, Mike. I know.
What am I going to, you know?
Hey, they're talking about toll booths now. You can
get
money.
Yeah, you could get more money, man. I'm telling you, this, you could sell products on there. Okay, Andy Richter, watch him. Thanks for coming by, Andy.
Well,
it's great to see you. And we'll be back right after blah, blah, blah.
You enjoy it?
Yeah, now my folks know how much I make, and they know they'll be hitting me up for more loans.
How many brothers and sisters do you have?
I have two brothers and one sister.
Well, thanks for coming in, man. I appreciate it.
It was fun. I had a good time.